The sky conditions here in our area do still have a few clouds, though, so the broken sky early will turn mostly sunny for the upstate by the end of the day, and that will really boost up these temperatures. We've got 50s and 60s for the upstate and northeast Georgia, generally low 50s in North Carolina with a few high spots in the 40s. With the sky clearing out today, the temperatures warm up significantly. Yesterday only got to 68 degrees. Today I'm calling for close to 80, so there's a major warm up coming. Mountain towns, you will end up in the middle 70s today with sun and clouds and just a small chance at a shower. So the overall big picture of the day looks really good. We're calling it a 9 out of 10 on the Carolina sky meter, and it should be pretty good tomorrow too. Here's the look at that afternoon future cast. A spot or two of rain does pop up. I do expect most of that to be in the mountains with the upstate basically staying dry. Future cast overdoing it a little bit today. Tomorrow, we actually have a sunnier sky for most spots. Looking at almost completely dry conditions, area-wide for your Friday. Into the weekend, we'll start to see a couple showers pop back up, mainly in western North Carolina. Not going to be a big issue here, but rumble of thunder can't be ruled out as temperatures start to heat up. And we're also watching the weekend for possible tropical development. There's a disturbance now north of Cuba and south of Miami that's going to likely move over the Bahamas between today and tomorrow, eventually pushing into the Atlantic, the western Atlantic, just off the coast, which has now a 70% chance of becoming a tropical storm. It would be named Arthur if it develops. But the good news about this, as it develops, and you'll notice it here starting to move its way into the Atlantic between now and Saturday afternoon, possibly getting that storm name, there's going to be a cold front that sweeps the nation, really impacting this storm out to sea and pushing it away from shore. So while the coastline could maybe see some high surf, maybe a brief sprinkle, it's really this cold front that's going to give us showers and storms by the time we get to Monday of next week, and that's going to really influence what happens into the later days of next week as Arthur, or the potential for Arthur, again pushes out to sea. We could see some lingering issues in our area with rain into Tuesday and Wednesday of next week as temperatures begin to fall a bit. So today and tomorrow, 70s to low 80s with sunshine. Saturday, mid 80s with sun. Sunday, 87 degrees. Even the mountains get into the 80s this weekend. Sunday into Monday is when we'll see that rain and storm chance tick up once again. Right now, I'm calling for a 20% chance for rain on Tuesday and Wednesday, but as the system potentially could stall over our area next week, we may see those rain chances increase. We'll talk about that a little more coming up. But of course, we want to get to your riding forecast, sponsored by Harley Davidson of Greenville. If you want to ride this weekend, it does look pretty good. Saturday's the better day to ride. It won't be quite as hot and it stays dry. Sunday has a late day storm chance, but if you ride early, should be good to go. Mountain towns, I would say ride Saturday. It's the best day to be out, 80 degrees, nice and dry. Sunday morning looks good for a ride, but the afternoon does bring a better chance for late day storms.